Kaylee, and today I'm doing the Fruit of the Spirit book tag. In case you didn't know, Books for MKs is a charity that donates books to missionary kids. If you want to donate to the kids, you can do so at GoFundMe.com. There's a link down in the description and there's a button at the end of this video. I got inspired to do this tag because I found this wonderful Etsy shop called Abigail and Avery, and they do folded book art. They sent me a sample of their amazing book art in exchange for a free and honest review, and I am so excited to show you guys this. They sent me this lovely book with a little ribbon and one of their business cards on it, and it says Faith. How amazing is that? Seriously, I have been staring at this thing for a good 10 minutes, just trying to figure out how did they fold it to be like that? I mean, how did they even know to fold it that way? It's like magic or something. I am so incredibly impressed with this lovely book art, and now the only dilemma left is, where am I gonna put it in my home? Where am I gonna display it, you know? I'm just gonna have to find the perfect place to display it. Seriously, I can't stop staring at it. It's like, I'm looking at every little fold in there. Like, how did they fold it like that? I just don't know. And I know you're probably all wondering, what book is that? And it's just like a generic fiction book. I kind of recognize that author's name, but I don't think I've ever read anything by that author. But yeah, it's lovely. So you can find a link to the Abigail and Avery Etsy shop down below. And they do all kinds of different book art, and it is absolutely fantastic. And getting that book art with the word faith on it is what inspired me to do the Fruit of the Spirit tag. This tag was created by Jesse Dawn, but I actually saw Lindsay from the BFCG do it, and I loved that she did this one, and so of course I had to, you know, imitate her and do it too. The first fruit of the Spirit is love. And you have to name your top three favorite book couples. This is so hard because I have so many favorite book couples, but one of my favorites ever is Margaret and John Thornton in Elizabeth Gaskell's North and South. Another favorite is from another Elizabeth Gaskell novel, Molly and Roger are completely adorable. And that's from her book, Wives and Daughters. And I think the third one I have to give to Cress and Thorn from Marissa Meyer's Cress from the Lunar Chronicles, because they are just too cute for anything. The next one is joy. Name a character who went through horrible trials, but they were joyful. For that, I'm gonna choose Nora Van Stone from Wilkie Collins' book, No Name. In this book, there are two sisters who, after their parents die, they find out that they are actually illegitimate children and that they can't inherit anything from their parents. And they're basically just thrown out into the world with, you know, with nothing. The older sister tries to plot revenge against the lawyers and people that have stolen their inheritance. But the meek and mild Nora goes to work as a governess or as a teacher in this horrible, squalid little school. And it's really, she's really in terrible circumstances, but of course she endures it with patience and joy. The next one is peace. Name a book where a river or a body of water is important to the story. For this one, I choose River Secrets from the Books of Beyrn by Shannon Hale. As you can tell from the title, you know, the river is kind of important. This is also one of my favorite books in this series, because it really focuses on a lot of character relationships. Next is patience. Name a book that you are anticipating reading. For this, I have the Reawakened series by Colleen Houck. Every time that she publishes another book, I've been buying up all the books in this series, but I haven't read them yet, because the last time I read one of her books, she left me hanging on this horrible cliffhanger and I thought I was gonna die. So now I refuse to read any of her books until I have the entire series and the companion novellas and anything that's gonna be published in that series. So I am definitely anticipating finally sitting down and reading this series. Next is kindness, and you have to name a selfless character. I had to think about this one, but I think I'm going to choose Mac Campbell from Rosenbloom and the Eight Cousins duology by L.M. Alcott. This is the same author who wrote Little Women, and the Eight Cousins and Rosenbloom duology is just as adorable and sweet and wholesome. And of course, the title character, Rose, falls in love, but her cousin, Mac, is always at her side, just helpful and kind and never asking for anything in return. Next is goodness, and you have to name a book with a plot twist that was so shocking that it had you saying, "Oh my goodness!" For this, I have Rebecca by Daphne du Maurier. This book actually has several plot twists, and every single one of them had me saying, "Oh my goodness!" This book is full of suspense and drama and intrigue and plenty of plot twists that will have you up until 3 a.m. because you just have to know what happens. Next is faithfulness. Name an author whose books you always buy without question. I have several auto-buy authors. They come out with a new book, I buy it. I find their book at a library book sale, it's coming home with me. But the one that came to mind immediately was Robin McKinley. I love her fantasy books. She does a lot of fairy tale retellings that I absolutely adore. Next is gentleness. And you have to show your most damaged book. I knew immediately what book I was going to show you guys. This is my Bible from when I was 4. I think maybe I was 3 when I first got it. Yeah, but I wrote my name on the side and the cover is completely falling off. And it's just, I mean, it's torn. Yeah, it's been taped together. It's been scribbled all over by my little childish self. It's in pretty bad condition, but you know what they say, a Bible that is falling apart is a sign of a life that isn't. So you stay in your Bible every day, your life will not fall apart. And lastly is self-control. Name the strangest place you've ever read because you couldn't wait to finish the story. Probably the strangest place I've ever read was when I was reading through Harry Potter. I read Harry Potter in church. Oh yes, yes I did. I think I was reading through the first or second Harry Potter book. It was the first time that I'd ever read Harry Potter, and I took it with me to church, and I put a Bible cover. You know how some Bibles will have like a fabric cover that you can stick other books in? And I stuck that in, I stuck Harry Potter into a fabric Bible cover so it looked like I was reading my Bible. And it was especially funny because at that time there was this whole Christian movement about how Harry Potter was of the devil and it was going to teach your children witchcraft and all kinds of silly stuff. So I felt especially rebellious reading Harry Potter in the middle of church. And that is the Fruit of the Spirit tag. Please leave a comment down below and let me know what would you have answered for these questions. And especially, what is the weirdest or strangest place that you have ever been reading? Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and remember, the right book in the right hands at the right time can change the world.